Hi, hello, hi. Welcome back to my channel. It's been a minute. I needed a little break. Life was getting a little crazy with my 9-to-5, so I needed a little break from YouTube, but I'm back. I only took a week off. I'm being very dramatic, but anyways. Hello, everyone. Welcome back to my channel. Thank you for clicking on this video. If you're new here, hello, my name is Megs. Today's vlog is one that I've been literally wanting to do since November. It is getting these crazy outgrown 2020 roots fixed. And so I'm about to head out to my appointment, so I figured I would just do my makeup and talk to you all. Yeah, life got a little hectic for a minute there. I was just working a lot at my 9-to-5 and then just, you know, needed some self-care, needed to take a little bit of a break to just focus on myself, but it is a wonderful day to be alive. We are finally, things are finally lighting up here in Winnipeg. Like, we are at the end of a 2-week, what was the word for it? I don't know, basically, Winnipeg froze for 2 weeks. Like, it's been, in the minus low 30s. High 40s for literally 2 weeks now. You can't really leave your house. You can't really do anything. And then they finally started lifting restrictions. So things like hair salons, things like gyms and stores and stuff now can be open, thankfully. So that's really nice. I think everyone's just kind of the mood's lightening up all around, which is really nice. And I finally got a hair appointment. So after growing my hair out, which is actually pretty long, it's touching my shoulders here. So I'm going to go get it cut and colored today. I feel like what I just said was a lot of babbling, but to be quite honest with you all, I'm actually running late. So I finished up work for the day. I'm just quickly getting ready and going to head over there. But I'm somebody who I think forever will be someone who's just always running late. I really have to try hard to be early for something. If I really need to be on time for something, I can be, but most of the time, I'm late. So let me know in the comments below if you're an early person, if you're always right on time, or if you're like me and you're always late. But anyways, I'm just chowing down on a really big smoothie as I am getting ready to leave. And so if you watch my vlog on my workday in my life, you'll know that I really just make the randomest smoothies. I literally throw whatever I have into a blender and I blend it up. So today's random concoction of a smoothie is, oh geez, this one was weird. Okay, so it was vanilla protein powder, Greek yogurt, coconut milk, banana, cranberries, cacao nibs, and coconut flakes. Weirdest combination, but it tastes really good. I'm really into putting cacao nibs in my smoothies lately. I just really like the crunch. It's like an added snack in your smoothie. That works for me. So since this video is about hair, let's talk hair. What on earth am I doing with my hair? Well, so basically what I want now is just kind of super similar to what I had prior to losing my hair, which was blonde hair. I don't know, for me, blonde is me. When I see this hair, the dark hair, I can't. If I pull it back, all you see is the dark hair. And I don't know, that's really not me. I love being blonde. I don't know. It's just, that's how I am. So I really just want to do an easy highlights, low lights with a little bit of roots. That way I can grow it out and it's not a very high maintenance hairstyle. I don't want that line. Yeah, and just have an easy hairstyle that I can just get refreshed once or twice a year. And that's basically it. Actually, let me finish my makeup, then we'll talk. Yeah, no, talking to a camera and doing your makeup and doing it well is a talent, and a talent that I do not possess. So to all the beauty YouTubers out there, you're talented. You are just talented. So anyways, my hair situation. So this is just over a year and a half. Yeah, a year and 7-8 months post chemo. And so basically I have three distinct layers right now. So I have this short layer right here. Then I have the secondary layer right here. You can kind of see if I turn sideways, I have a second layer. And then I have my bottom layer, which flips out half the time, flips in half the other time, and all of that. And then right now, all I have is my natural roots, which are very dark, and then my bleached hair. So basically, what I want to do, I don't know, ideally, I really just want to have it all one length. I'm just sick and tired of these layers, and I would really like to have it one length, but I look weird with it. Here, let me show you. So also want to go back to a middle part, but I still look weird with it. So if I do it like this, this short layer tugs my face, and then there's all these layers do weird things. So ideally my hair would be all one layer. However, if I cut it to the shortest layer, that would make my hair go like this. I don't think I'm okay with having short hair like that again. I don't know. What I think I'm gonna do, but then again, I don't know, it's just cut it to the middle. Sorry, I keep looking in the mirror behind you to see what I'm doing, but like the middle ground, which would be like here. So it's like, I think I'm gonna, oh yeah, that's kind of cute actually. So I'm gonna cut it to like maybe my like chin. And then that way there's like still two technically layers, but at least like they're not as like obvious. And I think I'll just ask the stylist to like blend the hair a little bit better. So it doesn't look like layers. It's just kind of like blended, like, you know, a little more subtle. Maybe I'll go back to the middle part and it's kind of cute. So yeah, that's the situation. I am running late, so let's go. It is literally so cold outside right now that the clock in my car is just frozen. Like, my car is telling me that it's 10:46 right now. It is in fact 4:30, so threw me off guard when I was driving and checking on the time. Anyways, it is so bright outside right now, which is actually so nice. So the one thing that I will give Winnipeg, even though like ideally like it'd be a little warmer here, but although we do have really cold winters, they're oftentimes really, really sunny. Like, I'd say 80% of our winter is just like beautiful sunlight with clear skies, which I think is super important. I am someone who needs sunlight. Like, sunlight makes me happy, and it just like makes me more energized and just makes me feel better overall. I definitely am one of those people that's like gloomy on a gloomy day. I say that I'm a sunflower. I need the sun. So that is one thing I will give Winnipeg. It is very bright, which is beautiful. Anyways, made it just in time. So I will see you with some brand new hair. First off, thank you so much to Rachel at Blush and Blonde Salon for transforming my outgrown hair into beautiful hair. So she started off by adding highlights that were the same shade as my bleached hair, and she did that all over my roots so that way I could still have some of my dark color there for dimension, but also have highlights and then not have that harsh root grow out. And this will also allow my hair to grow out easier, and there will be less of a line, and it will look more blended when my new roots do begin to grow in. And then she put in some toner, and then she did something on my roots, not too sure what it is though, to be honest, and then the haircut. And lastly, she curled my hair, and I honestly haven't had my hair properly curled in so long, so it was so nice. Good morning, it is a few days later, so it actually was really dark when I got home from my appointment, so I figured I wouldn't film in the dark, and so I just waited until my next hair wash day, which was today, to show you my new hair. I am so in love with it. Thank you so much, Rachel. This is exactly what I wanted. Like, I now can say I have a bob. It's like all cut down to one layer. Basically, I'm just working on like this short layer right here to grow it out, and then I will have hair that is all one layer, but I'm actually surprised with like how clean and even it looks. Like, I was worried that I was still gonna have like more awkward layers, but it ended up working out really well. And then she just blended this in here, so you can still kind of see that there's an extra layer here, but for the most part it just looks like normal layers. So this is my hair. I actually really love this length. I can't put it in a ponytail anymore, but that's okay. So I think moving forward, what my plan is going to be is just to like have shoulder length hair for a while, so long enough that I can put it in a ponytail when I need to, but short enough that it's like cute and fun, at least for a little while, until I get bored and want to grow long hair again. So I want to talk about quickly dyeing your hair after treatment. I know that I actually personally got a lot of messages from people being like, why would you destroy your hair? Why would you damage your hair like that? Like, you're just getting your hair back. And although I understand where you're coming from, obviously my body, my choice, and for me, getting my hair done is self-care. I'm a huge advocate for self-care, and I think that when something makes you happy, something makes you feel better, then you are just an overall happier person. And for me, having nice hair and having my hair done and feeling confident with my hair is a huge part of me feeling good. And for me, blonde hair, as I said earlier on this video, blonde hair makes me feel so good. Blonde hair isn't me. When I had my like new dark hair that was growing in, like, that's just, it wasn't me. And yeah, it's probably healthy. I mean, of course it's healthier to not dye my hair and to let the natural hair grow, but I wasn't happy with it. And I know that obviously bleaching your hair is not good for your hair, which is why I take really good care of my hair, which is why I take extra steps in my hair care routine to keep my hair healthy. And I only get it done once every like 6 months. So I think that if you are kind of in that fence of whether you should do it or not, if you think it's going to make you happy, I say do it. And then just like do your research, know how to take care of your hair to keep it healthy. So that is that. So on the topic of self-care, I moved to the living room because I want to do my nails, and I figured this would be a good time to do a little bit of a chit-chat about self-care. So on the topic of self-care, we all know that I am a huge self-care advocate, and To me, I think that there's no like one definition for self-care. I think that self-care is so different for everyone, and I think that it can change, like varying depending on like the season, or depending on what mood you're in, or depending on what phase you're on in your life. Self-care looks completely different. Like for me, for example, like I said, doing my hair was a huge self-care thing for me. For me, also doing my nails is a self-care thing for me. Now, when I was little, I could care less about doing my nails. When I was in high school, like I did them for special events, but like I could really care less about doing my nails. Versus now, like I love the look of when my nails are done. It makes me feel better. I think a part of it was also like when I was undergoing treatment and like I couldn't really, like I didn't have hair, I couldn't really do my makeup. Like having my nails done was also kind of like something maybe like that made me feel more like girly or more like myself, and I kind of carry that on and I just really like it. And so I think that self-care is super important, especially in times like these, but also just not having one definition of self-care. And I think that lots of people see like self-care online and they're like, oh, this is what self-care should look like for me. And that's not true. Like I show off self-care, and for me it is like a bubble bath is self-care for me. For me, a face mask is self-care for me. But then also self-care for me is like going out to eat to a restaurant so that way I don't have to cook sometimes, or sometimes it's going out for a walk so I get to spend quality time with people that I love and get some exercise. So I think we need to just really not think of self-care as like one single thing of like technically like taking care of your beauty or taking care of like your skin or something like that. Like self-care is such a broad term, and it's really self-care, like what you need to take care of you. And again, like I said, like it changes from season to season, it changes from time to time, can even change day to day. And so I think that it is just important to realize what self-care is to you and to do those things. And just because self-care is something to one person doesn't mean it has to be the same for you. With that being said, I will leave this video off here. So next week's video, I'm actually about to film it and I'm super excited to do it, is going to be a like all-in-one timeline of my hair growth. So I remember when I was going through treatment, I really wanted just a video, like one video that would show me like month one, this is what my hair looked like, month whatever, this is what my hair looked like, all in one video. And so I'm about to film that because I think that'll be awesome, just to see kind of the progression of my hair growth. And so that'll be people who are looking forward to like growing their hair back, or even just going from like a pixie to a bob, they can kind of ish see the timeline of it. So thank you so much for tuning into this video. If you did like this video, please give it a thumbs up. It really helps to support me and my channel. But for now, that is all. So know yourself, know your body, and until next time.